Hello everyone, in this video we'll see about Lacey's theory. In the last video we saw about Kennedy's theory. This is just an improvement on Kennedy's theory. So what did Kennedy say? Kennedy said that a stable or regime channel is where no silting, no scoring take place. That is, the sediment neither gets deposited nor it gets scored. So that is what is meant by a stable channel according to Kennedy. But Lacey differed in his theory. What he said was, true regime, that is true stable channel, can be achieved only if these three conditions are achieved. One is, there should be a constant discharge, and another is, the bed and the banks of the river should contain incoherent alluvium, which means loose soil that can be easily scored. The soil is very loose that it can be easily eroded and it can be easily deposited as well. So the soil type should be of this. And also there should be constant silt amount. And the silt grade also should be constant, that is the size of the particles, etc. So this is a very ideal condition which cannot be achieved. So he differentiated them into two types of regime. One is initial regime and other is final regime. Suppose let us say, from the river the canal is forming and it has just started to form. So based on the and etc., it will keep on changing its shape. If suppose it is a fine silt, it will be something like a semi-elliptical section, and if it is of coarser silt, it will be, the width will be even more larger, and depending on the silt size, silt gradation, etc., the width keeps on varying until a stable regime is formed. So this is known as initial regime. Here also silting or scoring does not take place, but the width keeps on varying. So it appears to be in regime, but the theory of Kennedy cannot be applied here. So that is what Lacey says. Lacey's theory can be applied only to true regime or to final regime. Final regime is when, as water keeps flowing, this width keeps on varying and finally some stability is achieved, where the depth, perimeter and slope is constant. Once this is achieved, it is in final regime. So Lacey's theory can be applied only for final regime and not for initial regime. Kennedy did not take into account this factor. So another thing which he differed from Kennedy was, Kennedy said that the eddies generate only from the bottom. So it is the silt factor was, silt supporting power was kind of proportional to the depth. But here he says that eddies form from the side also. He did not ignore the eddies from the side. So the silt supporting power is proportional to the wetted perimeter, that is the whole perimeter is taken into account. So that actually the eddies form from all the sides. So the silt supporting power, that is the silt which is in suspension, is by eddies from all sides. So it is kind of proportional to the wetted perimeter. And the silt factor which he applied was dependent on the size of the in mm. So he defined it as F equal to 1.76 root of d mm, where d is the average size particle in millimeters. Now let us see how to design according to Lacey's theory. So he provided an equation first for velocity. Velocity equal to qf squared by 140 to the whole power 1 by 6, where q is your discharge and f, you saw it is the silt factor, which is equal to 1.76 root of average size dia in mm. So first you find the velocity from this equation, then you find the hydraulic depth. Hydraulic mean depth r equal to 5 by 2 v squared by f. Then what you do is you calculate the area and wetted perimeter. So area, you know, Q is equal to AV, where you know the discharge, you know velocity as well from this equation. So you can calculate A, and wetted perimeter goes by the formula P equal to 4.75 root of Q. So you can find wetted perimeter as well. So based on area and based on wetted perimeter, you can assume side slopes like 1:2 or something and find the breadth and depth of the canal. So now the only thing left to find out is bed slope. For bed slope, he has given a formula, S equal to F power 5 by 3 divided by, so F you know is the silt factor and Q is the discharge. From this you can calculate the bed slope. Now let us solve a problem which came in IES exam. It's a simple straightforward problem where they have given the velocity descent by, according to Lacey's theory, is 0.88 meter per second, and silt factor they have given as 1.1 directly. So what will be the hydraulic mean depth? You know hydraulic mean depth is 5 by 2 V squared by F, which is 5 by 2 into 0.88 squared by 1.1. If you solve this, you will get 1.76 meter. So it is a simple straightforward problem. Now let us see what are the disadvantages associated with Lacey's theory. One is, as you know, like Kennedy, this is also an empirical formula, and a single factor F is not adequate. So just based on size of factor, F has been defined. So it is not adequate to represent the silt properties just by one equation. And also he did not define about silt grade or silt charge, how to take into account and all that. And also he did not talk about concentration of silt. So even Lacey's formula has some drawbacks like Kennedy's. This question I leave it to you. So this was also asked in engineering services exam. So they are saying, consider the following statements by Lacey and Kennedy. So the first statement goes like, theoretical concept of silt transportation is same in both. The second statement is saying that Lacey improved upon Kennedy's formula. Third statement is, there are no defects in either Lacey or Kennedy theory. So which of the statement is true? So you can answer this in the comment section. Thanks guys for watching the video.